Are you able to see the screen, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we discussed, like in last two classes, we discussed about basically what is JCL, what is COBOL, okay? Like what is VSAM and DB2. Apart from that, what is batch processing and online processing? Also, we discussed like COBOL data types, okay? There are numeric data types. Which we represent for numeric letters. So there is alphabetic. Let's say name can be represented, stored, declared with this variable, alphabetic. Alphanumeric, which is a combination of numeric and alphabet, we declare that as alphanumeric. So we discussed about sign and decimal also. So decimal, we had point and V. V will not take memory. Point will take memory. That is what we discussed. Apart from that, we discussed about level numbers also. So what is level numbers, what is group item, what is elementary item. Let's say if we take a student record, the student record we always consider as group item because there is no data on top of it. That is the starting point of data, basically, a student record. With respect to student record, let's say we consider a student name and date of birth. So this student record consists of basically student name and date of birth. So this is a group item and these are the elementary items because student record is further divided into student name and date of birth. And here date of birth is again divided into date of birth, I mean day, month and year. So here we call these as elementary items and this as group items. So with respect to these things, we call WS data name, date of birth as group item, but with respect to student record, we call that as elementary item. So this is what we discussed basically. And also we discussed like what are the basic level numbers in COBOL. So 0, 1 is basic, it represent record description or group item. 0, 2, and 49, we call that as elementary groups, or sometimes we can even call them as group items. So apart from that, we also discussed about 77, which means the elementary item cannot be further divided. So this is the last elementary item. So it cannot further be divided. That is what we discussed. Okay. So today we are going to start on other data declaration, data types. I mean, these are basically what we are going to discuss is comp, comp 1, comp 2, and comp 3. If we had time, we'll discuss about renames class and redefines class. So this is what we are going to discuss today. So why we need comp or comp 1 or comp 2? Because let's say whenever we take a variable, generally how do we declare a variable? Guys, anyone can tell me? I want to declare a what numeric data type. Does Can anyone help me how we declare numeric data type? Let's say salary. How do we declare this? We discussed it, right? How salaries our numeric data type will be described, declared. This is what we discussed.
With the 9.
Okay. So depending on length of the variable numeric data value, we declare that. Okay, so let's take salary, pick 9 of 4 we can take. Okay, so here the salary will take how much space? It takes 4 bytes. Okay, so this is what basically we are going to discuss. We are going to discuss in such a manner where the comp, basically the declaration, this declaration, what does it takes is it takes 4 bytes of memory in the space. So we want to decrease this space. There are few data types in COBOL which through which we can decrease the space. We can save the storage. Basically, these are only for numeric. So let's say one of those types is like saving memory with respect to COBOL is COMP. Apart from we had four basically: COMP, COMP one, COMP two, and COMP three. So COMP is one declaration where we declare this as basically see WS 01 WS where S 9 of 2 COMP. So how much this space does this take is, if you look at here this figure, 9 of 1 to 9 of 4, it takes 4 bytes. 9 of 5 to 9 of 9, it takes 4. Sorry, 9 of 1 to 9 of 4, it takes 2 bytes. So 9 of 5 to 9 of 9, it takes 4 bytes. 9 of 10 to 9 of 18, it takes 8 bytes. Basically, this is the basic storage, how does COMP takes. So this is one basic interview question. You should remember this. Take a note of this in a separate notebook, which I told you previously, to take only for interview questions. So you consider this. This will be one interview question. What is COMP and how data is stored with respect to COMP? So here, what does this mean is, if we take pick S9 of 4. So here we can store 4 bytes of data. Means till what 999 we can store, right? So with respect to these only, if data is between 9 of 1 to 9 of 4, we declare that as COMP. 9 of 4 COMP. We can declare this as 9 of 4 COMP. So here 9 of 4 says how many bytes are going to store here. So, but with respect to how much bytes will present on that variable. If let's say it is consist of 4 digits, but the data stored here is, we should take with respect to this. If it is between 9 of 1 to 9 of 4, here we have taken 9 of 4. So it is half byte. It takes only 2 bytes. Here it takes 4 bytes of memory. Okay. But coming to COMP, if the range is between 9 of 1 to 9 of 4, it takes 2 bytes of storage. Are we good here, guys? Team, please reply. Hello. If you are not able to reply, I cannot understand, guys. Whether you are able to understand or not, let me know. Speak out, please speak out. Raghu, Rajshekar, please let me know what you understood here. You there, guys?
Hello?
Huh?
Yes, sir. Too.
You understood what I mean to say here with COMP?
Okay. COMP, it is 2 bytes, it will take offered.
Basically, when we declare a variable like this, like a numeric data type like this, generally in COBOL, it takes 4 bytes. Okay?
4 bytes.
So when we declare same thing, let's say salary, your salary is now 50,000. No, let's say 5,000. Okay. If we take salary as 5,000, in general declaration, it takes 4 bytes of memory. Okay. But when we declare same thing with respect to COMP, let's say it is same, WS salary. Okay. S9 of 4 COMP. And the value is always 5,000. We have taken that as 5,000. But when we declare that as COMP, here it will take only 2 bytes. Because COMP range is, if 9 of 1 to 9 of 4, it takes only half byte. That is only 2 bytes. If it is more than 9 of 4, like 9 of 5 to 9 of 9, it takes full byte. That is full load. Which means it takes 4 bytes. Okay. 9 of 10 to 9 of 18, it takes double word, which is 8 bytes. Okay. Let's say if we increased one digit here, here it takes how much? We should declare this as how we should declare? Come on, guys. This is four digits. So we declare that as 9 of 4. If it is 5 digits, we declare that as 9 of 5.
Not five,
That
nine
is
of five.
what we discussed, right?
Okay.
So if it is 5 digits, it takes 9 of 5. We should declare that as 9 of 5. And this takes as 5 bytes.
Five
Okay.
bytes.
So coming to comp declaration, if we store, we should declare that as S9 of 5 comp. So how much bytes it takes here?
Five.
Here it takes 5. Here, see this what I highlighted. It should take basically 4 bytes because we are
Four
saving here
bytes, yeah.
memory. This is the basic concept we are discussing.
Okay.
The discussion is happening why we should take comp or comp 1 or comp 2 or comp 3. Why should we should we have numeric data types in COBOL? Why we are again having these numeric data types in COBOL again? What is the necessary? The necessity is we need to save the memory. So how we are saving that memory? If we declare a normal numeric variable 9 of 5, it takes 5 bytes. With respect to comp, we should declare that as S01 salary S9 of 5 comp. So here for 5 digits, S9 of 5. Here, the range is between 9 of 5 to 9 of 9. It takes only 4 bytes instead of 5 bytes. Are we good?
Okay.
Let me take one example. Salary is 9 of 10. How many digits we can give in this variable? What is the
10.
max value we can store in this variable?
8 bytes.
9 of 10. I am telling 9 of 10 in general declaration, how much it will take? What is the max value?
10 bytes.
10 bytes. What is the max value?
Yeah. 18.
Huh? Max value? You don't know numeric number. Basically, the max value of 10 digits is 999. This is 5 nines. There should be five more nines, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 10 nines we will get. This is the maximum value it will store. Right?
Okay.
So if we take that same declaration salary in comp, how we should declare this? Tell me how we should declare this. See this example and tell me how we should declare.
One salary yes 10
9 of 10, not 10.
S9
9 of 10, we
S9
should
9
call
of
that
10
as 9 of 10.
yeah 10 comp
So this is what we should declare. You should
yeah
understand the terminology also. If you tell 9 of 9, 10, they will understand you are not a proper trained guy or
yeah
no proper experience. It should
yeah
be
okay yes 9
termed as 9 of 10, S9 of 10. Okay.
Yeah.
How much space it will take? In comp declaration, S9 of 10, how much space it will take?
8 bytes.
Yes. We call that as double word.
Double word.
Okay. So these are basic interview questions you should remember. Are we good here, team? Any further more doubts? So we were discussing about saving memory. If we are saving memory, what will happen basically? How we will save memory? So for saving memory, we had four data types in COBOL: comp, comp 1, comp 2, and comp 3. We discussed it about comp 1. So comp 1, generally why it is saving memory is we save the data is stored in the form of zeros and ones. Instead of, let's say here S9 of 5 and value is 50,000. So it will store directly the 50,000 in this variable. The memory will be allocated for 50,000. But coming to comp, here the data will be allocated for zeros and ones only. So 50,000 will be converted into zeros and ones in binary format. And the value 50K is stored in 0 and 0 comma 1s. Instead of 50,000, the data will be stored in zeros and ones. Okay, that is what happens. That is how we save data here. Instead of 50,000, saving 50,000, that is saved with respect to zeros and ones. So that is how we are saving data. So S9 of 12, 9 of 4, it takes 4 bytes. 9 of 52, 9 of 9, it takes how many bytes? Please repeat. Guys, you there? 9 of 52, 9 of 9, it takes 4 bytes. 9 of 10 to 9 of 18, it takes 8 bytes. Okay, so this is one example of that. Okay, so how comp data is stored? Can anyone tell me what is the format of comp data storing? How data is stored in comp?
Binary format.
Yes, so what are the ranges of comp? Can anyone tell how much data will take for 9 of 5?
4 bytes.
9 of 5.
5 bytes.
Here it will take 4 bytes. If it is a general declaration, salary, pick 9 of 5. Here it takes 5 bytes. So general numeric declaration, it will take 5 bytes. If it is a comp declaration, it takes 4 bytes. So range is from 9 of 1 to 9 of 4, 2 bytes, 9 of 5 to 9 of 9, 4 bytes, 9 of 10 to 9 of 18, 8 bytes. This is the basic question they will ask in interviews. You should be able to answer this. Are we good here? Any questions? I think that has no. So let's go for comp 1 and comp 2. Basically, comp 1 is single precision floating point. Okay. Hello. Hello.
Okay. Yeah.
So comp 1 is single precision floating point. So how does the data is stored here? It generally takes 4 bytes of data. So the range is from 2 power minus 126 to 2 power plus 124. If the range is in between these ranges, we should declare that as comp 1, and the comp 1 will take data 4 bytes of data. Okay. This is called single precision floating point items. Comp 1 is basically single precision floating point. So data range is from 2 power minus 126 to 2 power plus 127. So how much data will comp will take? 4 bytes of data. Okay. 4 bytes means one word. So whatever you require to understand, I'm making that as highlighting. Okay. Generally, comp 1 and comp 2 in general projects we are not using much, but you remember what is comp, how much storage it will take. It takes 4 bytes, and what is the data notation? It is a floating point data. Okay, these two points you should remember. How much space it will take? 4 bytes. What is the data? How data is stored? As floating points, data is stored. This is what you should remember. This is not much required, but for your understanding, what is the range of single precision I have given here? Okay. And this is 32-bit format. Data is stored in 32-bit. We know, right, Windows is having 32 and 64. Similarly, ZBOS is having 32-bit format and 64-bit format. COMP1 is 32-bit format, and COMP2 is 64-bit format. That is what basically. So COMP2 is, this is a single precision floating point, and coming to COMP2 is double precision floating point. Here data is, how much memory does it take is 2 words, that is double word. And what is the length? 8 bytes of data it will take. Only maximum 8 bytes of data it will take. The range is from 2 power -10222 to 2 power +10223. This is the range. So what should we do, understand? Basically, it is a double precision data. Okay. Double precision data, and it takes 8 bytes. That is what we should remember basically. Okay. Guys, please tell me if you are not able to understand. I'll explain. You don't bother what is this floating decision, floating precision floating, or single precision floating. We never will. This is totally different standard, like ASCII standards basically. This is not required with respect to our COBOL. Basically, you need to understand how much data COMP1 will take, how much data COMP2 will take, and how we should declare COMP1 and COMP2. And we should declare this COMP1 and COMP2 only for numeric data types. These are the 4 points you should remember. Can anyone repeat these 4 points? First point, it is a floating point data declaration. Okay. It takes 4 bytes of data storage. Okay. And how we should declare that as WS01 WS var usage is COMP1. That is how we should declare. Okay. And what data types we should declare this? For numeric data types, we should declare COMP1. Okay. Even COMP1 and COMP2, COMP3, COMP also, we should only declare for numeric data types. The main point of this COMP, COMP1, COMP2, COMP3 is saving memory. Okay. Generally, COMP1 and COMP2, we never use that. Mostly, we use COMP and also COMP3. So coming to COMP3, COMP1, we store data as binary format. Here, data is stored as packed decimal format. Okay. So how much data does it take? One digit takes a half byte of storage. Let's say if it is having 10. So in normal declaration, that is WS01 WS var pic 9 of 2. How much space does it take? Can anyone tell me? Guys, please,
2 bytes.
2 bytes, right?
2 bytes. Yeah.
So same declaration with respect to COMP3. So we declare that as 01 WS var pic 9 of 2 COMP3. Okay, this is how we declare. Here, let's say its value is 10. It takes 2 bytes. Okay. Here, value is 10. How much does it take? Here, one digit will take 1 byte. Coming to COMP, one digit will take half byte. So here it will take total how much?
Half
Two
byte.
digits, right? So it will take how much?
Half
Total
byte.
1 byte it will take.
No,
Got it?
once again, repeat.
Generally, in COMP3, each digit will take only half byte. In general
Okay.
numeric declaration, each digit will take 1 byte of storage. Okay?
Okay.
You are good there, right?
Okay.
But in COMP3, one digit will take ऑफ बाइट ऑफ स्टोरेज. ओके, तो
ओके
हियर वी आर हैविंग टू डिजिट्स. सो फॉर ईच डिजिट विल टेक ओनली ऑफ बाइट. विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू टू डिजिट्स इट विल टेक वन बाइट.
ओके
ओके, सो दैट इज हाउ वी आर स्टोरिंग सेविंग डेटा. हियर इट टेक्स टू बाइट्स, इंस्टेड ऑफ टू बाइट्स इट टेक्स ओनली वन बाइट हियर. सो दैट इज हाउ वी शुड सेव वी विल बी सेविंग द डेटा वाइल डिक्लेयरिंग कॉम्प 3. सो द डेटा रिप्रेजेंटेशन इज इन पैक्ड डेसिमल फॉर्मेट. वन डिजिट विल टेक हाफ बाइट. टोटल लेंथ विल बी, लेट्स से इफ इट इज 9 of 2. सो इफ एन इज न्यूमरिक, एन सॉरी एन इज इवन. इवन मीन्स वॉट वी हैव टेकन, एन बाई टू प्लस वन. दैट इज हाउ द डेटा इज स्टोर्ड. सो एन बाई टू हाउ मच? 2 by 2, 1. 1 plus 1, it takes 2 bytes. Why 2 bytes is taken here? Because this sign is there, right? This sign takes half byte of storage in comp 3. Okay? Guys, are you able to understand? If it is having S9 of 2, S9 of 2, okay? And this is S. Okay, here it will take 3 bytes because we need plus sign here. Okay, here also we should have plus sign. Okay, so each byte, each digit takes 1 byte. So here plus 10 takes 3 bytes. Here coming to here, plus 10 takes only 2 bytes. Okay, are you able to understand? Why we are taking 2 bytes here? Because plus sign we are having, right? That plus sign will also take half byte. So how we should calculate that? S9 of 2 means it is a new even number. 2 by 2 plus 1. 2 by 2 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. It takes 2 bytes. Okay? Let's say it is S9 of 3. So value is 100 plus 100. Okay? So what is the formula for what odd number? 3 plus 1 by 2. 3 plus 1, how much? 4. 4 by 2, how much? 2. So it takes 2 bytes. Guys, are you able to understand or not? Let me tell me that. Hello? Speak up, guys. Please speak up. If you want explanation, I'll do one more time. Rajshekar, Raghu, any confusion or you are okay with that?
Okay, sir.
You got it right? How calculation happens? Okay. So that is what I want to discuss. I'll say what is the advantages of this comp and comp 3 tomorrow. We will discuss that tomorrow. I'm done with the session. Do you have any questions?